Hello students, in this video lecture, we will study about the design of bases for eccentrically loaded columns. When the base plates are loaded eccentrically, the pressure distribution from concrete does not remain uniform due to eccentricity. The compressive stress is maximum near one of the edges of the base plate and then decreases towards the other edge. Suppose this is your base plate and this is your column. So what it says, the maximum compressive stress is maximum at the near one of the edges. Suppose this is the maximum point and this is then the stress at this end will be minimum. Now suppose the column is subjected to a load P at an eccentricity of E, causing a moment M which is equal to P into E. Now it gives rise to a combination of axial compressive stress and bending stress. Here you can see in these diagrams there are the combinations of axial compressive stress and bending stress. The first diagram is stress distribution for the axial load. Now we know direct stress can be found out by the formula force upon area, that is P upon A1, and the A1 is the B into L. The B is width of the plate and L is the length of the base plate. Okay. And it is uniformly distributed, that's why we get a rectangular pattern. Now for bending stress distribution, calculated by M by I into Y, where I is the moment of inertia, M is the moment and Y is the CG distance. Now for the I, for the rectangular distance is 1 upon 12 BL cube. We putting this value in this formula, we will get 6M upon BL square, or M can be replaced by P into E, and we get plus minus 6PE into BL square, and this is shown in this bending stress distribution. Now combining these two diagrams, we get the combined axial bending stress, and the value is P upon LV 1 minus 6 E upon L at this end, and P upon LV 1 plus 6 E L upon this end. Clear? Okay. Now the combined stress can be calculated by this formula: sigma P upon LV 1 plus minus 6 E upon L. Now you have to remember this formula, it will be used in the numerical part. Note that it is desirable to have combined stress compressive because concrete is weak in tension. Now depending upon the eccentricity and the length of the base plate, the three cases are possible. The first case is when there is no tension, means A is equal to L by 6 or less than L by 6. And second case is when the tension developed is small, means E is L by 6 to L by 3, and when the tension developed is substantial, when E is greater by L by 3. So based on three cases, we will design our base plate. The length of the base plate required in all the three cases is kept minimum from economical point of view, and it is calculated in a way similar to that for an axial loaded column, which we have done earlier. Now the thickness calculated does not include the thickness of gusset angle. You have to remember this. Now first case is when there is no tension, means E is less than or equal to L by 6. So here in this diagram we can see that the stress distribution diagram, it is when you put value of E equal to L by 6 in the combined bending axial diagram, we get the following values: 2P upon LV at this end and 0 at this end. You have to put E by L value equals to 0 in this equations, and you will get this diagram. So this is our case 1, and on case 1 we will do numerical. Now here's the question: Now we have to design a base plate in example 5 point, which we have done earlier, and the column is subjected to a bending moment also of 16 kN and 120 kN. Design the anchor bolt if required. So we will focus on 16 kN in this video. So in previous example we have load P is equal to 1100 kN for ISHB 350. Now the moment is 60 kN. Now eccentricity can be created by E is equal to m by l. So value of m is 60 into 10 power 3, we change it to meter to mm. Upon 1100 we get the value of 54.54 mm. The minimum length of the base plate, for the minimum length of the base plate we assume 100 mm projection on each side of the column flange. So the length become 350, it is the length of the flanges, 2 into 100, 100 is projection on the either sides, so we get 550 mm. This is our length. Now the E by L is equal to 54.454 upon 550, we get 1 by 10.08, which is less than 1 by 6, so that falls into our case first. Now the bearing stress is 4 Newton per mm² for concrete, sigma c. Now we have to calculate the width of the base plate. The width of the base plate is calculated by this formula, P upon sigma c by L, 1 plus 6E upon L. Now putting all the values of P, 1100 into 1000, we have to do that. It is 1100 into 1000, 4 into 550, 1 plus value of A is 54.54 and the length is 550. So we get the value 797.49 mm, that almost we can take it at 810 mm. Now we provide a base plate of 810 into 550 mm. Now the next step is to calculate the thickness of the base plate. So for this we have to calculate the maximum compressive stress at the near edge of the plate, which is P upon BL, 1 plus 6EL, and we put the values here. You can see 1100 into 1000, 550 into 810, 1 plus 6 into 54.54 upon 550. We get the value of stress is 3.938 Newton per mm². Now we will calculate the minimum compressive stress. Similarly, P upon BL, 1 minus 6E upon L. Putting this value, we will get the stress at 1 Newton per mm². Now we have to stress at the critical section, which is lie outside the outer flange. Now here is your column and this is your critical section XX at the outer edge of the flange. Now to calculate this value of stress, how much stress is here, we use the linear interpolation method. This is the formula for linear interpolation method and I have written it down for your help. Now x1, y1 values 0 and 1, this is 1, and x2, y2 that is 450 from that point. The distance is 450 because this is the projection of 100 mm, and x-rays total is 550. So if we put all this value, we will get the 3.4038 value for this length, and this is the stress at section XX. Now for thickness, for finding out the thickness, we do moment at the critical section equal to the moment of H area about section XX. Now for calculating the moment of H area, now we have the values. This is a square, so WL square by 2, the W load is, the stress value is 3.40 into length is 100 into 100 by 2, and now this is remaining triangle can be calculated by half into base into 82. This is the length, this much length, into 2 by 3 of 100 at the center of gravity. This is the distance. So 18799.6 Newton mm what we get here. And the moment of resistance at the critical section is given by the formula 1 by 6 into 1 into T square into sigma Bs. Now sigma Bs value is 185. So 1 by 6 T square into 185 Newton mm. Now we equate these two, 1 by 6 T square into 185 equal to 18799.66, and after solving this we get the value of T 24.69 mm, and we can take it as 25 mm. Now, so the base plate dimensions are 810 into 1250 into 25 mm. Since the moment is small and is case of no tension, the nominal anchor bolts are provided and the anchor bolt design can be neglected.